So what I'm going to be doing for you today is playing a crystal bowl sound bath with some other cool instruments that I have here. And then I'll also do a Reiki distance healing session at the end. So this first part of the video is just sort of to introduce you to these concepts and ideas and how they can help us. So as we know, we're sort of going through these unprecedented times. And as coaches, we're very used to helping others, taking care of others. We're empaths. We have empathy for other people. So it's more important than ever now to also take care of ourselves, set some time to recharge your batteries. So being, yes, I'm a health coach, but I'm also a Reiki master and a sound healer. And so everything is energy. So when we're giving out energy to others, it's really important to, you know, again, just fill up our own battery, recharge ourselves. So this can be done through meditation, through taking a walk in nature, through, you know, hanging out with your pets and your animals, you know, family, reading something enlightening, anything that just sort of fills your own cup, because when we're all filled up, then we have more to give to others. So a sound bath is, if you've never heard of it, it's a really neat way to relax your mind, your body, your spirit, all of your cells, and all you have to do is lay there with your eyes closed and listen. So you don't actually have to do anything. That's what I love about sound baths. So each of these crystal bowls or quartz crystal, they're all associated with different notes. So we start with C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and then C. So each note is associated with each of our seven main chakras. Now, if you're not familiar with what a chakra is, it's C-H-A-K-R-A, so you can look it up and read more about it. And I didn't know anything about chakras until many years ago when I started to study all of this stuff. And so a chakra is basically an energy center within the body, and it's sort of like a wheel. So we have seven main ones, and there's others, but mostly you'll hear about the seven. So we have our root chakra, which is the lower area right around the tailbone. Usually the color for that chakra is red. And then we have the next chakra, which is our sacral chakra. So it's about 2 inches below the belly button. Usually the color for that chakra is orange. And then we move up to the solar plexus, which is about right at the bottom of the rib cage. This is our power center. Usually the chakra color is yellow. Then we move up to our heart. Obviously our heart chakra is a very important one. Usually the color is green, also can be pink for the heart. So our heart chakra will actually balance the lower three and the upper three. So that's the center. Then we move up to our throat chakra. This is obviously our voice, our expression, our sharing how we're feeling, speaking our truth. Usually the color is blue. Then we move up to the third eye, which is more like in the middle of the head, the pineal gland. The color is typically an indigo, so like a bluish purple. This is our intuition. This is our knowing. You know, this is just these insights where you just know something, or you just get a feeling about something. So that's our third eye. And then we have our crown chakra, which is the top of the head. Usually the color is the purple or even white. And this is our connection to all that is universal energy, you know, whatever resonates for you in that regards. So we want to have all of our chakras balanced, because basically they're wheels of energy. So they typically go in like a clockwise motion. Hopefully, just trying to think of how you're doing it. A clockwise motion. So sometimes they'll sort of get like, I don't like to use the word blocked, but kind of like stagnant, or they're kind of moving in the opposite direction, or they're just not moving as fast, you know, as fluently as they could. And the reason that happens is we'll be holding emotions in our body. Everything is energy. Again, like we're holding thought patterns, we're holding even like old past issues that we've dealt with in our, even when we're younger, we can hold this stuff somewhere in our body. So it's helpful to kind of always check your own chakras, do meditations to just help everything stay clear and balanced and flowing. So other forms that help with something like this, like getting everything, the energy flowing in the body, is like acupuncture, acupressure, all the meridians, things like that. So during a sound bath, so each of these again are attuned to each of the chakras. So if you think of us on a physical level, most of our body, our cells are like 70% water, right? So if there was water within one of these bowls and I was playing it, the water would actually start to jump, okay? So when you're listening to a sound bath, that's what's happening within our own cells, is the water sort of like jumping around, and it's kind of like a natural detox. So what happens during a sound bath is people will fall asleep, which is totally fine. You may experience emotions that kind of come up out of nowhere. Sometimes you have tears flowing down, just you're not really crying, but it's just something being released. You might feel like you need to like yawn or sigh, a sneeze even. It's just things coming out that you've been holding on to. You might have past memories that show up, insights or ahas that suddenly hit you, and something seems really clear to you all of a sudden. So all of it, sometimes you'll actually feel waves of energy, you'll may see colors. All sorts of things can happen, but a lot of people just fall asleep, and it's just a very deep, relaxing meditation. So the great thing about a sound bath is you're just laying there or sitting there, you're closing your eyes, you're listening. Yes, thoughts will flow through your head, just like let them pass like clouds in the sky, and then the sound will do the work for you. So then afterwards you might feel, again, if you kind of went through like a mini detox, you might feel like you want to drink extra water, take a little extra rest, kind of just be gentle with yourself. And sound baths, if they are open in your area at any point, it's a really great experience. Just go there, lay there. And they're all different. Sometimes they'll have gongs, sometimes they'll have all sorts of music, sometimes they'll have multiple sound healers throughout the room. Or nowadays, again, you can listen to sound baths. You'll be able to listen to the one that I record for you anytime, because that's going to be a separate little video. And anything online is always helpful. So then the second part of what I'll be doing for you today is a distant Reiki group healing session. Now, what is that? I understand. So I didn't know anything about Reiki till several years ago, where literally I was driving in LA and I was behind a car, and on the license plate it said, for Reiki. So me trusting my intuition, I was like, that's a sign that that's something I need to look into. So then I went to get certified in it, and I had never received a Reiki session prior, but during the certification session, and they receive an attunement at the end, which is basically a download of energy. And now I felt it. I was like, oh, and everything just sort of clicked for me. So even though some of these concepts may seem like new or not, you're not really familiar with them, if anything resonates with you, then I highly encourage you to read into it further, look into it further, because it's like your soul calling to learn some more information. So the word Reiki, so it's R-E-I-K-I, is a Japanese word that means universal life force energy. So this modality was discovered by a Japanese monk in the 1800s, and it's since been passed down through generations. So Reiki can be done in person. I've done plenty of in-person sessions, but what's really great about Reiki as well is that you can do distance sessions. It could be distance one-on-one sessions or distance group sessions. Now, why is that? Because energy has no barrier of time, space, or distance. I've done plenty of sessions with people in other states and even in other countries. They always feel the energy. They always have a wonderful experience. And then during the session, I often receive intuitive messages for that person to help them on their life journey. So, and even when you're watching a video or any sort of thing with energy at a different time, like again, you can watch what I film for you anytime, it's as if it's happening right at that moment. So that's why it will help you in that moment too. So again, there's no barrier of time, space, or distance when it comes to energy. So essentially with Reiki, the practitioner, again, I'm a Reiki master, so I've gone through the ranks, and again, I never knew anything about it, but it was like my soul was just calling it to me. And there's other forms of energy work and energy healing modalities. several different ones, and you just kind of like figure out what makes sense for you and what doesn't. But everything is energy. So Einstein figured this out a long time ago, right? So essentially what the practitioner will do is kind of tune in to this energy, and through the hands will basically direct it to that person. And I always do hands above the person. I always have anyway. And now with distance, it's just via video or we talk on the phone. They're in their home, I'm in my home, and it's the same, they have the same experience. So I will pretend they're in front of me, and on their end, they're having, you know, the healing experience. So just like the sound bath, emotions come up, things just want to come out, release from the body. Some people feel energy, waves of energy, see colors, feel warmth or tingles. But it's just the energy working through you, and it's always for your highest and best good. There's no way to do this wrong, and you only take in, the body only takes in what it needs at this time in safe and easy ways. So that's always my intention. I only work with love and light and, you know, the highest vibrational energy that exists. So the practitioner will direct the energy through the hands to the person, and then at the end of the session, they'll sort of separate the energies again. And it's really amazing. It sounds out kind of out there, I know, but it's been around for centuries, and especially now at this time when we really need to keep balancing our energy. We're empaths, we're picking up energy from everywhere, and you can just imagine all the stuff floating around, right? So you really have to find your peaceful center every day, do your meditations, do your grounding, get outside in nature if you can, put your feet in the grass, which helps to ground you immediately. And just always, again, just to recharge your battery. So I'm going to get all set up. So the next video is just purely gonna be the sound bath portion. So I encourage you to get all comfortable wherever you are, in a nice, comfortable space, laying down, sitting, wherever you'll be. It'll probably be about a 15 or 20 minute sound bath. So you can just be completely relaxed. And then it's kind of nice, like, if anything comes up during your session, to have a little notepad next to you so you can just write it down, any thoughts that come in or any ahas or anything that sometimes it just wants to get out on the page.